Consultant General Surgeon Goldie Khera speaks to Mark Walker now about New Year resolutions. It's not too late to have one, but sticking to one can be difficult.
So I'm here with Goldie Khera, Consultant General Surgeon at Montefiore Hospital in Hove, but also the Royal Sussex County Hospital. Welcome back. Happy New Year, Goldie.
Happy New Year.
New Year's resolutions, a lot of them are healthcare related, aren't they?
I think that's actually quite a good thing to do. You know, kickstart the year, I think it's always a nice thing to say. So just some tips and tricks about what to do in that regard. So, New Year's resolutions throughout the years have all been hit and miss, and, you know, you try your best. But I think if we can start in the new year how we mean to go on, and I'd basically just say it should be three things. So you need to eat healthy, be healthy, and then get help. And that would be my three. So eat healthy would be that the usual. You'd expect me as a consultant to tell you to drink less alcohol, to stop smoking, but actually if you can cut down your portion sizes and have what you're eating to be less sugar, less processed foods, more healthy, you know, home-cooked food as much as you can, and I think that's the key really to doing that. So if you can have that sort of mindset that, you know, apart from the occasional treat, that you are having stuff around the house that you're going to be careful of buying, ethically sourced as well as you can. And I think if you're having that sort of food around yourself and your family, I think that's a fantastic start.
Yeah, and gym memberships, they often don't last, do they? People have them, but they not always taken up over.
So gym memberships are you know, obviously a tricky one. So they tend to try and get you onto a year's membership, knowing full well that majority of their customers will only attend for a short length of time. And the way I think to do that is to actually give yourself some time for yourself. So if you're thinking, I mean, we recommend that you do some sort of exercise that's going to raise your heart rate at least three times a week. So whether that's a walk on the beach, whether that's, you know, a gym exercise, or whether that's a more sporting, you know, team-based sport, at least you do one of those activities or three of those activities in a week. So that's the key. So if you can do that, you're going to be staying healthy and being healthy as well.
Yeah. So gym membership's not always the answer, but
no.
it's good if you can.
Yeah, if you can afford it. It's expensive, but if you can afford it, that's fantastic. But if you you know, you want to be outside, then walking on the beach. We've got dogs, so dog walking. You know, you can be environmental. You can clean up on the beach. I mean, we always make sure that we collect plastic and rubbish every single time we go to the beach, just to do our bit.
Yeah.
Walking on the downs. So then we're so lucky in Brighton that we can do all these outdoor things. We've talked before about cycling, so you can really get healthy and, you know, and cycle around. So I think
it's a good one, cycling, isn't it?
It's really good.
Yeah. Okay. And what happens if you break that resolution? And you just got to do the best you can, haven't you? Really.
Got to do your best you can. I think you've got to keep your mental health, you know, up to speed as well. So I think you should be probably volunteering or giving your time or giving your money, whatever you can to neighbours, to the elderly, to whatever, you know, you're interested in. So I think from that point of view, if you can try and do something new in the new year to actually give either your time or your money, whichever you've got.
Or both,
if you can. I think that would be a key. So we've got volunteers at the hospital. We've got volunteers for the elderly, for children. And it's just literally worth its weight in gold. And we couldn't have a hospital as it is without the volunteers that we've got.
Yeah.
And whether it doesn't have to be the health sector, it can be, you know, other sectors as well. It can be as simple as knocking on your neighbour's door and seeing if you can do
yes.
a chore for them. I think that sort of thing we can give and take in a neighbourly way.